Okay, na gut. Soll sein. Dann nehme ich jetzt auch auf. Und heiße alle willkommen in unserer fünften Folge quasi. Also nicht fünften Folge, sondern im fünften Szenario. Passt. Hartmann, du warst dabei, irgendetwas zu erzählen. Hurra! Okay, tue ich doch gerne. Seeing movement in the tower up above has cemented your decision and you begin to race up the stone steps. As you ascend, the pyramid eventually tapers into a giant spire shooting up into the sky. You grab the handholds carved into the vertical face of the stone structure and begin to climb. Halfway up to the tower, carried upon the ever-increasing winds, you begin to hear the sounds of commotion below you. A multitude of wormlings are pouring out of the base of the pyramid and moving up the stone steps after you, completely unable to fend them off while clinging for your life. You have no choice but to continue climbing upward towards the zenith. Farther still, up your ascent, with the storm below hot on your heels, you begin to hear troubling sounds from above as well. The sound of a woman yelling. You recognize the voice of Dryles. You climb as fast as you can. Wie kommt ihr da drauf überhaupt? Finally reaching a large open circular platform to stand on. Above you, you can see two more smaller platforms and it seems like Dryle's voice is coming from the very top. Getting there will not be easy, however. Demons and more of the wretched Blackbiters block your path. When we sacrifice the small one of them taunts. The demons will make this island ours. Special rules. All attacks made by any figure have push, added as a scenario effect. Flying figures are immune to this specific push effect. Ah ja. Fällt das dann auch die Stiegen runter?
Das kommt gleich. Okay.
So, na gut, dann gehe ich zurück zu den Regeln. Wo waren wir? Ah ja. The three map tiles are not connected normally, but are considered to be on top of one another. With the C tile on top, the D tile in the middle and the M tile on the bottom. Consider the walls of these tiles open space, such that if any non-flying creature is pushed into a wall on the C or D tiles, that figure falls onto the next tile down, e.g. C to D or D to M, okay, into the most logical corresponding unoccupied edge space. For instance, if a figure is pushed off the top left of the C tile, it will land on the top left edge of the D tile. In the case of M, ja, ich sehe das jetzt leider nicht, was du herumdingst, aber was soll's. Ich hoffe, die anderen im Stream sehen's. Und Andi und Michi. Hm. In the case of ambiguity, players decide which edge space the figure lands on. When a figure falls like this, it will suffer half the damage of a trap rounded up, and any additional unresolved push value is negated. Characters can also willingly move off the edge of the C and D tile for one movement to fall down to the next tile, but they will still suffer the same damage. Also zwei Punkte Schaden nehme ich mal an, oder? Interessant, und ich dachte, die Kleine ist in der Mitte. If a non-flying, non-character figure is pushed into a wall on the M tile, it dies instantly, and no money token is dropped. If a character is pushed into a wall on the M tile, he or she suffers trap damage and does not move. Whenever a monster pushes a character or character summon, the push will always be closer to the wall closest to the pushed figure. Set up all three rooms at the beginning of the scenario. There is no line of sight between the rooms, though focus can still be found between rooms in order to move from one room to the room directly above or below it. Figures must move from one stair or rubble hex to the corresponding one in the other room, spending the requisite two movement for difficult terrain. Even flying and jump movements are subject to this extra movement, contrary to normal rules. The A stairs connect to each other, the B stairs connect to each other, and the figure can move from either C rubble to the L rubble and back. Ist das L rubble? Ja. Jetzt bist du weg, ich höre dich nicht mehr.
Treten wir, wenn sie gleich raufgehen will, braucht schon vier
den Jump auch so.
Egal ob du Jump oder Flying oder was auch immer hast.
Mhm.
Du hast immer diese, du bist im Spiel disconnected.
Ah. Ich sehe mich allerdings noch im Spiel.
Ja, aber ich. Du wirst nicht mehr sehen, dass du da viel.
Ah ja, jetzt bin ich disconnected. Interessant. Na okay, ich steig nochmal ein. Mhm. Hallo? Hui! Oh, Gebitte. Ich muss noch mal aussteigen.